Hey you guys, ew, I sound really sick. But I'm starting out with my dirty hair that I had in braids for like a month when I was wearing my wigs. Look at that gunk. And I'm getting ready to wash it. And I used Jamaican black castor oil shampoo and just some herbal essence conditioner. And now I'm about to determine if I should blow dry it or not. This is me thinking about it. I really don't want to use heat on my hair, so I decided not to do it. And I'm going to take these bundles that I got from the beauty supply. Some hair ties. My Eco Styler Gel, my Beeswax, and my Gorilla Snot. Now I'm going to stretch out the bundles and go ahead and lay them on my door so when it's ready for me to use them, I can go ahead and use them. And now I'm going to section off my hair. Well, I'm going to start by doing the little side part that I want for my buns, making sure it's straight and everything. And once it's straight, I'm going to section off my hair in the front. I'm going to do a hair tie on the sides. And then I'm going to do two buns in the back. And then I'm going to section off the hair on the other side too near my edges. Just so when I go through and lay the hair down section by section, the hair won't get in the way. Now I'm going to take out the back section. Get me some drink before I even start anything. Now I'm going to make sure I comb out all the knots and crinkles and curls. Y'all, I'm so weird, like for real. I'm putting my Eco Styler Gel on it. And then I'm going to put my beeswax on it. And then I'm going to comb it out and brush it on there just to make sure the hair stays down. And you guys, I like to go through and do this throughout my hair because it makes my hair lay flat. Since my hair is natural and I'm not going to blow dry it, I want it to lay really, really flat. So going through and doing this throughout your hair and throughout the sections will make it last longer. It'll make it lay flat, and I don't know, it's easier to manage this way and go through and make sure everything's combed out. So I'm going to go ahead and do this on one side of my head. I'm not going to show you on the other side because it's self-explanatory. And plus you couldn't really see me do it on the other side when I was filming this. So I'm going to go ahead and be quiet and you guys can see what I do. Before I start the other side, I'm going to add some oil on my edges. This is peppermint oil that I got from the beauty supply store. I'm going to go ahead and start on the front, doing the same thing that I did with the sections in the back, adding gel, beeswax, brushing it, combing it. You already know the drill. you guys, I wanted a little swoop in the front, but I didn't want it to be like on my forehead because I don't know, hair gel and stuff breaks out my forehead around that area. So I used my toothbrush, adding some more beeswax, combing it. It took me forever, but I finally got it. You guys, adding water helps activate the product more and disperse it throughout your hair. So if you see your hair like not laying well, or like you don't want to add any more product, go ahead and add a little water, it'll help. Y'all, this could be a look, like the slick back like that. That could be a look. I could wear that to prom. Y'all, this is where I messed up. Do not use the Gorilla Snot Gel. Like, you already use a whole bunch of wet products on your hair, you use water. The Gorilla Snot Gel makes it not up. Do not use that. Use the freeze spray just to like hold it down, but don't use the freeze spray either because that like makes your hair a little crusty. Use a different hairspray. Now I'm gonna put my scarves on. I put on two of them just to make sure I lay my hair, and then I'm gonna take my blow dryer while I have the scarves on and blow dry it down, because I didn't want to like film it the next day. I wanted to go ahead and put the bundles on my hair and stuff before I lay down with the scarves on. So I'm gonna blow dry it a little bit just to take away that dampness before I go ahead and add the bundles on the hair. So while I'm taking the bundles, I'm going to take a little piece and wrap it around wrap it around my hair so it can go ahead and stay on as I wrap and won't fall off. And I wrap it around like a couple times and add a pin just to make sure it stays on my head and doesn't fall off. And then I'm gonna keep on wrapping, adding pins, keep on wrapping until I get to the end. All right, when I get to the end, I take a little piece and I go ahead and wrap it around the hair so it'll stay. And then I take another piece from the ponytail and wrap it around too. You guys, I like to make sure it's secure because I don't want to be the one where their whole bundle falls out of their head or something like that. Like, that scares me to death. So I'm going to go ahead and secure it down. And I'm going to repeat the same thing that I did on the other side. Now I'm gonna go ahead and create my buns. I'm gonna just wrap it around, add the hair tie, play with it a little bit, see where I need to add pins in it. Now the other side was falling out, so I'm gonna go ahead and repeat the same thing on the other side. Make sure the buns are even, so one is not too high, one is not too low. Hey guys, this is where I also effed up. See those little rolls on the back of my head? You do not want that. So when, before you even put the bundles on your head, make sure that your hair ties are loosened up. Like, maybe my hair ties were too tight. That was probably it. Make sure your hair ties are loosened up before you add the bundles. But I was too lazy to go back, so I just go ahead and dip my edges. You already know. Swoop, swoop. I added these clips on my hair to make sure it stays down since my hair is still kind of short. And that's the look. We're all done. We're all finished. Make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.